Keith, what exactly is going to happen here?
So first off, what we're going to do, we're going to make some shoe buns, another name you're using for these profiteroles. So that's we're going to do them now.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So firstly, what we need to do is take one packet of butter, cubed up, and a pint of water.
A pint of water.
What we're making is shoe pastry. All right, so we melt the butter, we simmer it, and then what we do then, we add the flour. Here it goes.
Is it self-raising flour?
Self-raising flour, yeah. So you'll see in a second, it'll come away from the sides.
Of course, Keith, you've been a chef all over the place. Most notably, you were a chef at the Savoy Hotel in London.
Yeah, I did some experience down there, and I went and worked with a chef called Glenn Watson. And I stayed at his house, and he was the executive chef of the Savoy. So I worked there with him, and then I worked under Ansel Edelman, the Savoy. It was a very, very good experience. I mean, it taught me a lot. Obviously, you worked with a lot of chefs as well. There was 84 chefs there when I was there. And you worked on the Escoffier hot plate. So it was, yeah, it was really good. Very good indeed. It's all perfect size. That's what you want. There we go.
Well, you've given that a right good kneading.
I know, yeah.
You have. You've kneaded that very well.
Right.
So
straight to the mixer. Now, we've got 12 eggs here. We should add them in slowly.
What size eggs?
The medium eggs.
Medium eggs.
Yeah. If you're adding large eggs, you want to add less because obviously you don't want your batter too sloppy. Run it so it's firm and it'll puff up. If it's too sloppy, it'll just go like a pancake. I mean, that's what we don't want. You add them in slowly. You turn the mixture on a bit higher. See, it's just. Maybe just get me a pan bag from me, please. There we go. So what we're going to do now, obviously we've taken the end off there, and we're just going to pipe it into here. See how the mix is there? See the mix? It's quite firm. You don't want to be too sloppy, otherwise it'll just
amazing, you could turn it upside down, it won't fall out. This will be in an ordinary oven.
It'll be
an
ordinary oven. Just put a little tray of water underneath, and it'll create a little bit of steam and a little bit of lift. The thing about this as well, you can put other things in it. If you wanted to make some savoury shoe buns, you can. You put some spinach in it, you put anything in the mix, and it'll cook it within the batter. So we usually do some savoury ones, you know, some patty filled ones or some foie gras ones, or just some, and it's good for not just for a sweet dish, it's also good for a savoury dish as well.
So you've got the piping to do, and you're going to put it on here,
yeah.
Which is a buttered tray.
Yeah, buttered dish. You can use grease proof, you can, you know, either way, but with our ovens, with the fan assisted, usually the paper can curl up. With this also as well, you can make them as small and as big as you like. And what the French do, they have a dessert called a gâteau centenary. And what that is a coffee dessert. And what you do is you pipe the whole tray as one, and it puffs up, and you cut it in half, and you pipe it with a coffee liqueur, and they use it as a cake. And that's the other way that the French do. But in England, we just tend to use profiteroles.
And how many people would this serve? Would you give one person one profiterole, or would
usually
they have two or three?
I mean, you'll see when they come out, they'll come like this. So there'll be two, really. I think three's too much, unless you're really hungry, of course. That goes straight in the oven. 160 degrees. Right, ready? That's profiteroles. Out the oven.
Right, Keith, what are you going to do now?
Right, what we're going to do is just going to stack them around, and we're going to make a little tower, and then we're going to pour some chocolate sauce over.
Wow.
These are stuffed with a raspberry, white chocolate and amaretto mousse. Now what we're going to do is just going to put them around here, like so.
They look like Yorkshire puddings.
They do, yeah. These are the big shoe buns.
So we've got the raspberries.
The raspberries there, just put them around.
Are they frozen raspberries or fresh?
Fresh raspberries.
All fresh?
All fresh. Fresh is best.
Now what sort of chocolate is this?
This is a Belgian chocolate. This is Caliber chocolate. This is very, very good chocolate. It comes in collets. And what we do is just basically we boil some water, and we put this on top and it melts. And we put double cream in. Je ne sais quoi? homemade chew buns with raspberry and amaretto mousse with hot chocolate sauce.